Hi, everybody. Natasha Koch with the Van City Home Team. A little bit late for my live. I guess I'm still on Mexican time. So thanks for waiting, everybody. I drove to Mexico this year. I don't know if anybody knew that we were driving. So it was a little bit spotty for Wi-Fi coming back. So that's why we didn't have any lives last week. So anyway, as you can see, I'm all bundled up because it's cold here and snowy. So today's topic is all about getting homeowner insurance. And we're going to talk about the four costly mistakes that homeowners make when they're getting insurance. Hi, Melanie. How are you? Happy New Year. Are we still allowed to say Happy New Year in February? I hope so. Okay, so I'm going to talk about the four costly mistakes that homeowners make. So as we know, when you buy a house, you need to get house insurance. Whether it's a house or a condo, both places you need insurance and you need adequate insurance. And when I say adequate, I don't only mean the insurance that your lender requires of you, because they are really only protecting their interest, of course, and their investment. So you want to make sure that you're covered as well for some of the things that we need to endure or that you need to endure in the area that you live in. So let's talk about number one. So number one mistake is underinsuring. So obviously we tend to go by the lender's recommendation on insurance. And so you want to make sure that you read the fine print. A lot of cases you're financing a home at 80%. Thank you. Yes, I'm glad you're good. Awesome. Happy New Year. So you may be financed at 80% or 90%, but really you want to make sure that you're insured on your house in case anything happens for the full rebuild of your house. Because obviously, if the property values go up or the cost of building goes up and you're only insured to cover what's owing on the mortgage, you're not going to be able to rebuild that house, or it's going to be substantially more and you may be surprised if something happens. So please make sure that you have enough coverage. If you need some guidance, most insurers will give you an estimate of rebuild cost, or talk to a builder, realtor, just to make sure, and do this every year when you go to renew your insurance, because obviously cost of building and property values go up. So number one, don't uninsure your house. Don't try to save some money. It could cost you a lot in the long run. Number two, make sure that you have adequate insurance, like flood insurance. We live near the ocean, everybody. Or if you're near, you know, if you're in an area where there's hurricanes or windstorms, you know, earthquakes, you want to make sure you have earthquake insurance. In a lot of cases, we're required here to have earthquake insurance automatically. It's a requirement for financing, but make sure that you have it regardless, especially if you're in an area that is prone to some of these different kind of storms. Because you don't want to be in a bind if you did have an earthquake and then you have no coverage. Hi, Claudia. Thanks for joining. Okay, number three, thinking that you just have a flat deductible. Check out your deductible. The deductible is the amount that you're responsible to pay should anything happen, and those deductibles vary. So you want to make sure that you know what they are. In some cases, you can have different deductibles for different items that are wrong. So if you have a flood, you know, if you have, you know, some Mother Nature natural disaster, you know, there might be a different deductible. Even some insurance policies have a percentage deductible, and it can be as much as 5%. You know, if the overall cost is huge, then your deductible may be out of your affordability. So make sure that you check what your deductible rates are. They are not all the same. And number four, are you covered for mold or sewage backup? These kind of things happen and there is coverage for them. Don't think that insurance is only for natural disasters, you know, or freak storms. Sometimes, you know, there could be a sewage backup. It floods everything in your house and you may be surprised. You do have insurance coverage, but you shouldn't be surprised because you should already know what your policy is. So read through your policy, increase it every year. I mean, I know that most of us will not have to utilize it, hopefully, knock on wood, but it is definitely better to be covered in case something happens, you know, rather than having to put out of pocket expense that you may not have and be in a position where you won't be able to fix your house if there is a problem. So those are the four costly mistakes. There are a few other mistakes that you could make if you're moving into a condo. There's some other insurance policies that you want to have a look at. So if you want any of these tips emailed to you, just PM me your email address. I'll add you to the list and we'll see everybody. I'm going to do a housing market update. Now that we've gotten through the month of January, I'll do that on Thursday. So we'll see everybody at the Van City Scoop Live on Thursday. In the meantime, I'm sitting here in my onesie and I'm going to stay indoors during the snow and the cold. Have a good night, everybody. Thanks for joining. Bye-bye.